Good evening, students. Today we shall discuss Indian Constitution. I have come with 50 questions and also the answers. I shall show you the questions and answers, and wherever necessary, I shall discuss with you. All these questions are very important from your exam point of view. I am hopeful that you will like the questions. You will read them and you will also remember the answers. First question: who was the temporary president of the Constituent Assembly? And as you can see, the answer is Dr. Sachidanand Sinha. On the very first day of the Constituent Assembly, Dr. Sachidanand Sinha was elected as the temporary president of the Constituent Assembly, but that was a very temporary arrangement. Next question: who was the chairman of the drafting committee? Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. We all know that Dr. B.R. Ambedkar is the father of Indian Constitution. There were so many committees formed for framing the Constitution of India. One such committee was the drafting committee, and Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was the chairman of this drafting committee. For your exam point of view, you should remember that the drafting committee was a 7-member committee. There were total 7 prominent members who were given the responsibility of drafting the Constitution of India, and Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was the chairman of this prestigious committee. Question number 3: who was the permanent president of the Constituent Assembly? So, as I said earlier in question number 1, Dr. Sachidanand Sinha was the temporary president of Constituent Assembly, and permanent president of the Constituent Assembly became Dr. Rajendra Prasad. You all know that Dr. Rajendra Prasad, who is popularly known as Bapuji, was an ardent follower of Mahatma Gandhi, and he came from Bihar. He also became the first president of our country, Dr. Rajendra Prasad. He became the president of India for consecutive 2 times. Question number 4: who was the legal advisor of the Constituent Assembly? And the answer is B.N. Rao. His name is B.N. Rao. He was an eminent jurist. He was a lawyer. His name was Benegal Narsingh Rao. Question number 5: how long the Constituent Assembly took to prepare the Indian Constitution, the largest in the world? It took 2 years, 11 months, and 18 days. Why I have given the answers? So that there is no confusion among the students. So the answers have been given ready-made. But the most important thing is that all the questions are very important. So a student should not neglect any of the questions, and they should remember all the answers also. Question number 6: Indian Constitution was adopted by the government of India on which date? And the date is 26th November 1949. Question number 7: Indian Constitution was enforced by the government of India on, answer is 26th January 1950. This 26th January is a very important day in the history of India. Earlier in the year 1930, all the congressmen of India observed the Independence Day of India on the 26th January of 1930. To honor this day, later on, the framers of our constitution have decided to enforce the constitution on the particular date of 26th January in the year 1950. And since then, we have been observing this day as the Republic Day of India. Question number 8. Part 3, Article 12 to 35 of the Constitution deals with fundamental rights. We all know that we have six fundamental rights, and these rights are enforceable, they are justiciable, and these rights are essential for a decent standard of living of every citizen of India. Question number 9. Which article contains right to freedom of speech? Very important. Right to freedom of speech is contained in Article 19. Article 19 contains right to freedom of speech. There are six freedoms guaranteed in Article 19, and the very first freedom is the freedom of speech and expression. Question number 10. After which amendment, right to property became a legal right? Initially, in the very original constitution, there were seven fundamental rights. But later on, the right to property was deleted from the list of the fundamental rights. It was Article 31. Right to property was Article 31. Later on, it was deleted by the 44th Amendment. And today, our right to property is no more a fundamental right. It has become a legal right under Article 300A. So now, right to property is a legal right and mentioned in Article 300A. It is no more a fundamental right. Question number 11. Which article describes the election of President of India? Mainly Article 55. Both Article 54 and 55 describes the election of President of India, but majorly Article 55 tells us about the election procedure, the electoral college, etc., etc., about the President of India. The term of President of India is 5 years. Which article lays down the procedure for impeachment of the President? Article 61. Now, what is impeachment? President is the first citizen of the country. It is very respectable post, and a country is identified by its very first citizen, that is the President of India. So President of India cannot be disrespectfully discharged from his duty. So there are certain procedures. If it is required to remove a president from his post, then one particular procedure has to be followed. This particular procedure is known as impeachment. The concept of impeachment has been borrowed from the Constitution of USA. And the impeachment procedure has been detailed in Article 61. It is to be mentioned that so far none of our presidents have been impeached. Question number 14. Who is the ex officio chairman of the Council of the States? Council of States means Rajya Sabha, and this is our Vice President, who is the ex officio chairman of the Council of States. Who is the present Vice President of India? Venkaiah Naidu is the present Vice President of India. Question number 15. Who is the authority to decide any dispute in connection with the election of the President and Vice President? Supreme Court of India. This is the apex court of India, and this has been given the responsibility of meeting up any dispute regarding the election of President and Vice President. This comes under the original jurisdiction of our constitution. There are certain jurisdiction of the constitution, like original jurisdiction, appellate jurisdiction. So this comes under original jurisdiction. So question may come this way also. Deciding upon the dispute of election of President and Vice President comes under which jurisdiction of the Supreme Court? And your answer will be original jurisdiction. Question 16. Who gives advice to the government of India upon legal matters? So government of India will get legal matters from the highest law officer of the country, and the highest law officer of the country is Attorney General of India. Attorney General of India, from Attorney General of India, you will get so many questions like Who was the first Attorney General of India? Then the Attorney General of India has been mentioned in which article? This is Article 76. Very important. Attorney General has been mentioned in Article 76. Question number 17. Who is the authority to decide whether the introduced bill is a money bill or not? So from money bill you can expect a lot of questions. First question may be, money bill is mentioned in which article? This is article, money bill is mentioned in article, money bill may be in article 110. And the authority to decide whether the bill is a money bill or not, that will be decided by the Speaker of Lok Sabha. Now let us move on to the next questions. I shall start with question number 18. Money bill can be introduced only in the Lok Sabha. True or false? It is true. Money bill is not like any ordinary bill. Any ordinary bill can be introduced in any of the houses, but any ordinary bill may be introduced either in Rajya Sabha or it may be introduced in Lok Sabha. But in case of money bill, that will be introduced only in Lok Sabha. It cannot be introduced in Rajya Sabha. Question number 19. A bill which is related with revenue and expenditure of the government is called, it is called finance bill. So remember, not all the bills are money bills. All the money bills are finance bills. But all finance bills may not be money bill. Question number 20. The term of members of Rajya Sabha is 6 years. Very important. How many members are nominated by the president in the Rajya Sabha? 12 members. So, eminent personalities from the fields like, different fields like arts, science, social service, they are nominated by the president in the Rajya Sabha. 22. How many members are nominated by the president in Lok Sabha? Actually, it will be were nominated. Nowadays, there is no nomination of members in the Lok Sabha because after the 104 number amendment, amendment number 104, further Anglo-Indian members are not nominated by the president in Lok Sabha. This has been curtailed after the amendment number 104. But prior to that, two members from the Anglo-Indian community were nominated by the president in the Lok Sabha. Question number 23. The retirement age of the judges of Supreme Court is 65 years. Retirement age of judges of High Court is 62 years. Which article provide? Now, this article has been removed, so the question will be, which article provided special status to Jammu and Kashmir, Article 370. Question number 26. Under which article, powers and duties of the Comptroller and Auditor General of India are described? Article 149 and 150. All the important questions, dear friends, please try to mark up. Under which article reports of the CAG relating to the union are submitted to the president? Article 151. Now, what is the function of CAG? It's nothing but to have a look on the receipts and expenditures of the government. So, every year, the CAG takes an audit of the receipts and expenditure of the government on different projects and then finally submits a report to the president. So the post of CAG is very important in maintaining the financial transparency of the country. Question number 28. In which year Election Commission of India was established? 25 January 1950. That's why this 25 January is known as National Voters Day. Who was the first Vice President of India? Dr. S. Radhakrishnan, Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, became the first Vice President and second President of India. Who was the first woman judge of the Supreme Court? She was Mira Sahib Fatima Bibi. In which year first Lok Sabha election was held? 1952. At the time, who was the election commissioner? The election commissioner that time was Sukumar Sen. Which constitutional provision concurrent list was borrowed from which country? So the concurrent list along with the union list and state list are mentioned in the 7th schedule. The idea of concurrent list has been borrowed from the constitution of Australia. The model code of conduct for political parties and candidates to be followed during election is specified in very important question. Very important question. Representation of the People's Act 1951. Who is the chairman of Lok Sabha? Who is the chairman of Lok Sabha? And the answer is, Speaker is the presiding officer of Lok Sabha. He is the commanding officer of Lok Sabha. And who was the first Speaker of Lok Sabha? First Speaker of Lok Sabha, if you can remember, first Speaker of Lok Sabha, if you can remember, was G.V. Mavalankar. My handwriting may not be good, but you can, if you are listening to the audio carefully, you please write down the name. His name is G for Ganesh, V for Vasudev, Mavalankar. Next questions. Which articles empower the President of India to appoint Prime Minister of India? Article 75. Which has the most profound influence in framing the Indian Constitution? The Government of India Act 1935. Very important. Who is the chairman of the National Integrity Council? Prime Minister of India. In the Union Government, the Council of Ministers is collectively responsible to Lok Sabha. It's a five-star question. Five-star question, very important for your exam. In India, when both offices of President and Vice President happen to be vacant, who will discharge duties of the President, that is Chief Justice of India? One such event arose in India when Justice M. Hidayatullah acted as the President of India. Who determines the salaries and allowances of the members of the Parliament in India, that is Parliament itself? You should remember that our Parliament consists of three elements. Our Parliament consists of the President, the Lok Sabha, and the Rajya Sabha. British Parliament passed the Indian Independence Act on 18 July 1947. Total number of fundamental rights in Constitution of India is 6. From Article 12 to 35. Article 12 describes state. Article 13 describes law. Article 14 to 18, right to equality. Article 19 to 22, right to freedom. Article 23 and 24, right against exploitation. Article 25 to 28, right to religion. Article 29 and 30, cultural and educational rights. Article 32 to 35, right to constitutional remedies. Total number of schedules in Constitution of India is 12 schedules. In the original Constitution, there were 8 schedules. But later on, after amendments, we have added 4 more schedules. Now today we have 12 schedules in the Constitution of India. Which article of the Constitution defines Panchayati Raj? Article 243. Under Constitution, Article 343, which is the official language of the Union? Official language of the Union is Hindi and English. Which community gets special provision for central services in Article 336? Anglo-Indian community. Which constitutional article lays down the provision for a national commission for SC and ST? Article 338. So you have to remember these articles. Article 336, 338, they are important articles. Before the independence of India, Dadra and Nagar Haveli was under the administrative control of the Portuguese. You all know that the Portuguese came to India in 1498 before all the European powers, and they were last to leave the country. The Portuguese power in India, that was in Goa, Daman and Diu, that ended in the year 1961. Question number 49. Who decides allotment of symbols to political parties? Election Commission of India. Who has the authority to approve presidential rule in the state? Parliament. My dear friends, today I have discussed 50 questions with you. Along with the answers, I hope you have enjoyed this session, and in the next session I shall come up with another 50 questions. I am trying my level best to upload the videos and posting it in the WhatsApp group, and in lieu of that I am expecting your feedback. Please give me the feedback in the WhatsApp group itself so that I can improve my video and audio quality in the next classes. Thank you. God bless.